You don't want to throw away that 100 million gallons of nearly perfect quality drinking water. Why not clean it up that little bit more and get it back? And then all of a sudden, a lot of our water issues have disappeared. Nobody is going to drink water if you tell them they have antibiotics in the water or estrogenic steroids or poisons, carcinogens, toxins. All these things have to be taken out before you and I will drink the water. And so in a sense, you have to make it even cleaner than drinking water from regular sources in order to convince the people that it's okay. Orange County Water District in Fountain Valley interested in cleaning up wastewater to the point where it can be directly reused. To clean up their water, they do a lot of filtration, and at the very, very end, they use a radical-based system called an advanced oxidation process to do the final cleanup. And groups like mine are very interested in the chemistry of how this occurs, how efficiently, how well, what do you make, is it better or worse, so that at large scale, when they do it, they can tell what's happening with their water. So that's what we do. We use chemistry. We then can tell the public what is going on, how it is cleaned, what is left, and at this point saying it is safe to drink, it is potable, it is good for you, and it's cheaper than getting new water. A lot of my students, they're interested in the health professions. This is environmental health. Clean water is the number one problem in the world in many ways right now. My students get to have their own project. They get to do something directly that will help the world in many ways. It's also fun chemistry. I mean, it feels good to be able to say, yes, I can make a significant achievement. I can make a progress. I can understand something that will help